Hello and welcome, I'm BoteX, and today I want to do an update video on my previous video where I showed how the 6900 XT performs on ARK. In my previous video there was a whole lot of problems with the 1% lows and there was a whole lot of frame drops which made the game look really not nice. So since then I played around with AMD's overclocking software and with some tweaks on there I managed to sort out the problem. So here is the settings that I've changed. Okay, so here we're on Radeon software where you can tune or overclock your graphics card. So I went here to performance, then tuning, and I select manual. So from here I also enabled GPU tuning, and then from here I set the maximum frequency to 90%, which is about 2300 megahertz. Because on this card it actually goes up to 2500, and I left the voltage alone, so that's still on 100%. Previously I did think I needed to mess around with the minimum frequencies, but yeah, that really didn't make a difference. Then on the VRAM I changed the memory timing from default to fast timing. I think that actually makes the biggest difference. And then on the memory frequency, I just took it from the default 2000 to 2040. I don't really think that makes a difference, but I like to do it anyway. But on fan tuning, this actually I think also makes a difference, because on default, the fan curve is really not good at all, because it allows the card to go up to IT almost 90 degrees. I don't know why AMD does that, but I set the fan curve much more aggressive. Even with this setting, it runs really cool, like 61, 65 thereabout. But the fans still don't run up that fast. So it's not really a big deal, and it runs much cooler now. Right, that's it. That's all the settings I've changed, and now ARK and other games runs much better. Alright, let me just show you that the game actually really runs smooth now. There's no more frame drops. It's not perfect yet, but it's a whole lot better. Like, normally if I just come in here, already there will be some frame drops that you can really notice. So as you can see, the low 1% low still goes like a little bit lower than it should, but I can't really notice it anymore. And the Epic graphics actually looks quite nice on 1440p. Right, that's it. I hope that will help you if you're thinking about getting this card. And then thank you everyone for watching and have a nice day.